Hey, when you get a chance, give me a call. Dad, I know you're watching Survivor right now. Give me a call. I think it on Netflix. Hi, JC. This is Brace calling from the Great Harvest Bakery Company in Delafield.
Hey, Will. It's Caleb.
Call me back.
Are people afraid of you, Beth?
Uh-huh.
Who's afraid of you, Beth?
John. Wonder.
Your brother, why is your brother afraid of you?
Because I haven't seen him.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And what, at nighttime, what do your parents do to your door?
Lock it shut.
Why do they lock it shut?
Because they don't want me to get John.
Right. And they're kind of afraid of hurting John? Are you hurting John?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Are they afraid that you might hurt them?
Yep.
Would you, Beth?
Mm-hmm.
When would you do it?
Nighttime.
Okay. Why would you do nighttime?
Because I don't like them seeing me do it. But they can tell me to.
Mm-hmm. And what would you do to them, Beth?
Stab them.
Okay. What would you stab them with?
I don't care what anyone says. I love Brittany. And if anything ever happens to her, if she ever commits suicide because of a fucking idiot video, I mean, because of a fucking idiot blogger, I will kill myself too. Get well, Brittany. Just know that. And how fucking dare anyone out there make fun of Brittany after all she's been through? She lost her aunt. She went through a divorce. She had two fucking kids. Her husband turned out to be a user, a cheater, and now she's going through a custody battle. All you people care about is readers and making money off of her. She's a human! Leave her alone! You're lucky she even performed for you, bastard? Leave Billy alone!
Listening to DJ Hunt.
You got this. pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
We are the product of aliens who designed, thought us up, built this, put us here on Earth hundreds of billions of years ago, and they just keep producing humans. The souls are tempered by lifetimes of experiences on places like Earth. Only when they reach an automatic alignment are they released from the nurseries of evolution. Some have difficulties, some never make it. You go back to Earth or another prison planet and try it again. Human forms are pretty common throughout the universe where there's humans in the same program. The solar system here is just an illusion. When we die, we go into reality. The soul is one heck of a thing, more fantastic than even the galaxies. It's big, very big, and so amazing they can squeeze all that into a clueless human brain.
This emergency warning message has... Your area is affected. Take all necessary precautions. And listen to any local radio, television, or cable outlet for further updates. Do not use your telephone for the duration of this emergency.
I have a dream that she's going to come back, that the person we buried was not her.
I am God. Yes, hello.
Day one. I'm waiting. same day over and over again. My life is like a broken record. Day two. I'm living the same day over and over again. My life is like a broken record. Day seven. I'm living the same day over and over again. My life is like a broken record. Day 30. I'm living the same day over and over again.
Ambitions, ambitions beyond what you will ever understand.
That's funny to you.
Well, it's a little bit funny, don't you think?
This is a terrible place.
DJ Han. You look at me.
Every morning he got up, dreading each moment he had to be awake. He'd look at the floor for one gum wrapper. He never found a better way to joke around. The clock would tick and time would slow. He wasn't anywhere he wouldn't go to avoid having to see anyone. He'd sit in a chair, lean against the wall. It just didn't seem to matter much at all. But late at night, he had a savior in his sleep, in his dream. She came to him and she said, for you, no one understands you, for you. And every word that everyone would say got mumbled up in his head, like mumble jumble, everyone would.
Cherish it while it lasts, because one day it will be gone. Everyone you know, everything you know, every memory, every joy, every happiness, every pain, every pleasure, gone.
We'll be right back. big fire is howling. My girls scream out my sorrow. Is it today? Is it today I'm dying? As the big bird lands, life hits me hard again.
I'm keeping time while I watch the hours bleed.
You are now listening to DJ Hunt.
Just like you should. My neck, my back, lick my pussy and my crack. My neck, my back, lick my pussy and my crack. My neck, my back, lick my pussy and my crack. My neck, my back, lick my pussy and my crack. My neck, my back, lick
first you gotta
we're all bored now.
But has it ever occurred to you, Wally, that the process that creates this boredom that we see in the world now may very well be a self-perpetuating, unconscious form of brainwashing created by a world totalitarian government based on money? And that all of this is much more dangerous than one thinks? And it's not just a question of individual survival, Wally, but that somebody who's bored is asleep, and somebody who's asleep will not say no? See, I keep meeting these people. I mean, just a few days ago, I met this man whom I greatly admire. He's a Swedish physicist, Gustav Bjornstrand, and he told me that he no longer watches television, he doesn't read newspapers, and he doesn't read magazines. He's completely cut them out of his life because he really does feel that we're living in some kind of Orwellian nightmare now, and that everything that you hear now contributes to turning you into a robot. When I was at Findhorn, I met this extraordinary English tree expert who had devoted his life to saving trees. Just got back from Washington, lobbying to save the redwoods. He's 84 years old, and he always travels with a backpack because he never knows where he's going to be tomorrow. And when I met him at Findhorn, he said to me, "Where are you from?" And I said, "New York." He said, "Ah, New York, yes, that's a very interesting place. Do you know a lot of New Yorkers who keep talking about the fact that they want to leave but never do?" And I said, "Oh, yes." And he said, "Why do you think they don't leave?" I gave him different than Al theories. He said, "Oh, I don't think it's that way at all." He said, "I think that New York is the new model for the new concentration camp, where the camp has been built by the inmates themselves, and the inmates are the guards, and they have this pride in this thing they've built. They've built their own prison, and so they exist in a state of schizophrenia, where they are both guards and prisoners, and as a result, they no longer have, having been lobotomized, the capacity to leave the prison they've made, or to even see it as a prison." And then he went into his pocket and he took out a seed for a tree and he said, "This is a pine tree." He put it in my hand and he said, "Escape before it's too late." See, actually for 2 or 3 years now, Chiquita and I have had this very unpleasant feeling that we really should get out. That we really should feel like Jews in Germany in the late 30s. Get out of here. Of course, the problem is where to go, because it seems quite obvious that the whole world is going in the same direction. See, I think it's quite possible that the 1960s represented the last burst of the human being before he was extinguished, and that this is the beginning of the rest of the future now, that from now on there'll simply be all these robots walking around, feeling nothing, thinking nothing, and there'll be nobody left almost to remind them that there once was a species called a human being with feelings and thoughts, and that history and memory are right now being erased, and soon nobody will really remember that life existed on the planet.
This is a Hunt Radio exclusive.
Is someone else in this house? It's not hard to figure out who it should be. A good question for the people who do this, the agents. Who are their other victims?
Thank you.
Ecstasy, depression. Embark on the amazing journey of life, and lose yourself to the rhythm of thoughts and emotions. Along the way, you will face many challenges and solve timeless mysteries. Now remember, no matter how blissful or dark it gets, life is life, and it's all yours.